So we're working on a solution to reduce the use of intravenous sedation, which are a high cost and high complication drug in intensive care units.
The big stakeholders in this area are the payers, certainly insurance companies, including Medicare, and as well the administrators at the hospitals, especially because the predominant population of patients that end up in the intensive care unit are in the Medicare population. And increasingly, intensive care is being under-reimbursed for that population. So anything that helps gets the elderly patient better, faster, from the ICU to the ward is something the hospital administrator is really going to love. As well, the pharmacy doesn't like paying for extremely high-cost medications that are being used right now for these IV sedatives. So any reduction in that makes them a positive stakeholder. Certainly the patient is a positive stakeholder. In this case, they're certainly receiving arguably the most benefit out of the technology, but because of where they fit in the relative power stream, they don't have a lot of say about how their care is practiced within the ICU environment. But at the end of the day, I think the realities of care in that high intensity environment dictates that hospital administrators make the choices and then the payers decide what gets paid for. In terms of understanding how much value we could extract from the system in terms of pricing, that was a bit of a different kind of nuance, because on the one hand, you have all of these downstream complications you're avoiding that are, multi-billion dollar big ticket items every single year, and you're improving care and improving patient comfort. On the other hand, people are looking at it and they're saying, this is a $2 tube. You're going to ask me to pay what for this? And so there's a bit of a balancing act between that pendulum. So the kind of middle ground that we found was that by tying our pricing to the sedation itself, we were able to really focus in on value that we could capture without having to prove out all of those downstream clinical reductions and outcomes. Because all we had to do is over a short period of time, 24 to 48 hours, was prove that we could reduce the amount of sedation by half, 20%, 30%, whatever it's going to be. And then that corresponds to a dollar value reduction in sedation price. Sedation itself costs between $400 and $800 per day, depending on patient size and dosage and et cetera. So if you can reduce it by half, that's $200 to $400 in savings, which gives you a hard direct cost number for us to get in on a daily basis that would be saved from using the wishbone device. And then we can start to worry about the value provided and the other complications downstream as we start to do larger clinical studies off the cell of this device.
One of the lessons that we learned from our market analysis was that if, despite the fact that we are potentially saving, in the thousands and thousands of dollars for every patient, there is a ceiling to the ASP, and understanding what the care community is used to seeing in terms of pricing for medical devices, understanding exactly what the competition costs to the hospital, and that's not always an easily answered question because of the complexity of reimbursement. Those are the kinds of things that I think are worth spending a lot of time on to truly understand, and to understand that may be the fundamental ceiling to a price point and to defining a market opportunity, rather than the actual savings, although the savings itself is a powerful driver to adoption. In terms of just the intra-hospital dynamics and dealing with pharmacy budgets and ICU budgets, we learned that the global assessment of the value to the hospital is far more important now than the value delivered to individual departments. And that's a change from probably 5 to 10 years ago, where individual hospital departments were very concerned about their local budgets, where there was very little attention paid to the global budget of the hospital. And that has completely changed now, and has changed both our market analysis, but also informed the stakeholder analysis as well.
The dirty little secret is, don't just trust what the internet tells you. Actually go talk to people and get them to tell you what they think, who actually are in the market, who know what things cost, who know what they're spending, who know why they're choosing one product over another. That's really where the intellectual nuggets of wisdom are, as opposed to, you know, certainly the top-down analysis is great from an initial sweep, but once you get that initial sweep done, you really got to go talk to people on the ground to figure out what's, you know, smoke and what's actually real.